a book says such and such, as if his book is the one that revealed and your book is not revealed, so you have to be convinced if he tell you that the Bible says. So since you don't believe in my book, neither I believe in your book, okay, what you have now, so let's find a different means to judge, and this will be the logic, because everybody agrees that 1 plus 1 equals 2, so 1 orange plus 1 orange is not going to be 3 apples, you see? But you could not tell me the Bible says, the Bible says, so I can tell you the same way, the Quran says, but we never go any place. So, the logic here, although I have things to understand from the Bible that we can see that the crucifixion was not true. But the logic is, if God died, so why we worship God? Because some believe that Jesus is God. If God exposed to death can die, so why we worship God? Because I'm going to die. And God was dead for 3 days. So if we are equal, so why I'm submitting myself or worshiping and devoting myself to one who is equal to me? Because God has to be above me in everything, in knowledge, in wisdom, in mercy, forgiveness, in ability, in power. But if me and God are equal, or God worse than me because God was dead and I'm still alive, so I'm better than God. It doesn't make sense. So, if he's not God, but he's son of God, so why God did not save his son? Which one of you will see something happen to his son and will stand watching? And if he's son of God, the son takes the nature of the father. Because the chicken when lay down an egg, it doesn't come a monkey out of the egg, will come a baby chick. So always when a father and mother are married and they have a baby or be a human being, it's not going to be a baby cow. So if God has a baby, he's going to be a baby God. That means he can grow one day to be a God. So if the son of God, it has to have the nature of God, the father. So if the son can die, so that means the father can die. So that means the son dies today, but later on, also the father will die. The last thing, because logic can go to the end. So now, if God was dead for 3 days, according to some people believe, what has happened during these 3 days? I'm sure some of you heard about the blackout long time ago, about 10, 15 years, I forgot. I was here in America, in New York, I think maybe in the 90s. And you know what happened? And this was like, what, 8 hours, whatever it is. How many stores been robbed? How many people been killed and all these things? So can you imagine that the electricity is missing for a few hours? All this corruption happened. Can you imagine if God abstained or dead for 3 days? What's going to happen? Is there a chance anybody wants to kill, wants to commit adultery, wants to steal, wants to do anything? Hey, you got a green light, do whatever you want. So the logic, it doesn't even help. But if we come to debate it from a pure point of view of your book and my book, it has a long story that we could not say for the time being. But before I close, I take the last minute to say that I'm alhamdulillah, very grateful and thankful to the whole community. I know you didn't see me last week, so this is the reason I could not say thank you. But the last khutbah, 2 weeks ago, if anybody still remember, we talk about the Somali refugee, we talk about the immigrants and the Ansar. So alhamdulillah, and also we talk about the treaty and the book of Sufism, about participation in the classes. So with the general, but the main thing was about the Somali refugees. So alhamdulillah, with a good response out of the community, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you all. Towards donation that I collected approximately $500 towards the book of Sufism and the CD, the tape of Brother Ali. the marriage of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But the beauty of it is not the $500. Because I know some of you wrote $1,000 before. But the beauty of it that most of the community, if not all the community, had contributed. And one beautiful thing that a brother came with the 10 cents by Allah. A brother came with the 10 cents and said, brother, this is what I got. I said, Jazakallah khair, I appreciate it. And this is a copy of the book, if you don't even have one. So the good that everybody participates and everybody donates. So even if it was $10, that everybody made an effort. Alhamdulillah, Jazakallah khair. Also for the Super Sunday, Alhamdulillah, was very fruitful. The program was very successful. May Allah bless you all and brother Musa for his effort. And approximately about 150 people had participated in the program. And some people even remained sitting here and playing and having fun until Maghrib. Also after the khutbah, one brother came and gave me $600 cash. And said this towards the Somali fund. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward him and you too. Also, I got a donation of 2 cars, running cars, for this purpose. And also, his sister has called me. I said, I have a car in my backyard. It needs to be fixed. If it can be used, I would like to donate it also towards. So, alhamdulillah, this is so good. And also, we got 3 or 4 brothers. They said, brother, this is my phone number. When you need me to take them to office, to take them someplace, I'm available. So I'm very grateful to your contribution, to your participation. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continue to reward you. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep you, inshallah, well. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep you to do the good for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We're still looking for your participation in the classes. And this is very important because everything else you can have it outside. But the most important thing of the mission of the mosque is dedication to the Salah. Alhamdulillah, we see the participation in Salah more. We need more participation in the classes. We have the Saturday class that Riyadr gave it. And we have also the class by Brother Musa every Friday. And the Brother Ali, inshallah, also is going to have a specific day for his classes. So I'm very grateful and thankful for your donation, your participation. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continue blessing you for this. On your behalf, because I was not here last week, I would like to welcome the brothers and the sisters and the children from the Somali who had arrived to Colombia. And also I would like to send a word of appreciation to the Lutheran Church and those people who work with the program. We have 2-3 families. They came, some, a church came with their van to bring a family. Another lady came with her car to bring a family. And another people brought. So we're very grateful to what they're doing towards the Muslims. We appreciate this. And we say to anybody who's doing good, regardless of Muslim or non-Muslim, Almighty Allah will bless you for it. In this life or in the hereafter, in both. We say again, وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ رَبِّي وَرَبُّكُمْ فَاعْبُدُوهُ هَذَا صِرَاطُ مُسْتَقِيمٍ.
In conclusion, we ask Allah that He brings you benefit through this lecture. For more information, you may contact us through the following address. The Islamic Propagation Office, Rabwa, P.O. Box 29465, Riyadh 11457, Saudi Arabia. Phone 445-4900. Also 491-6065. Fax 497-0126. If you would like to listen to more beneficial lectures, feel free to visit our website at www.islamhouse.com. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.